ذاك الأيام فتى وتنحي.
بل نقذف بالحق على الباطل فيدمغه فإذا هو زاهق ولكم الويل مما تصفون.
الإمام ابن تيمية رحمه الله has mentioned regarding the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regarding the arsh, and he has said regarding the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he's brought a few narrations. He's brought a narration regarding that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sitting on his throne. Yajlisu alayhi. Allah is sitting on his throne. And then he's mentioned that Allah, while sitting on his throne, he's left a space of four fingers all the way around. He has left the space of four fingers all the way around the arsh. And he's mentioned that that some ahli hadith, i.e. the people of hadith, the people who have knowledge of the hadith, have mentioned that this hadith is weak. But then he mentioned, لَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ أَهْلِ السُنَّةِ قَبَلُوهُ, that majority of the ahli sunnah have accepted this hadith. Now, I would like to ask the question to those brothers, that is this the true creed of the Sahaba? No. Is this the true creed of the Salaf? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sitting on the throne and he has left a space of four fingers? No. Then he further mentions that the most authentic opinion is that Allah is sitting on the throne. On page 483, we can look for our own, is in volume number 8, under the chapter of Kitab al-Tafsir, Min al-Zumar ila al-Masad. He mentions there that the most authentic opinion is that Allah is sitting on his arsh, but there is no space of four fingers. There is no space of four fingers. The reason Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah says this, that if we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sitting on his throne and there is a space of four fingers, this will mean that the arsh is bigger than Allah. That the arsh is bigger than Allah. Therefore, we have to reject the narration where it says that the space of four fingers, and we'll have to accept the narration where Allah, where the Prophet also mentioned that Allah is sitting on the arsh, but there is no space. I would like to ask a question down here. If Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayhi is rejecting that hadith on the basis that the arsh will be bigger than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we believe that he has left space, a gap of four fingers, then if there is no space and gap, what does that mean? The arsh and the Allah is
equal.
Is equal. Na'udhu billahi min.
الحمد لله رب العالمين, والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, as you've all heard the statement that came out of the mouth of brother Muhammad Yasir Hadahullah regarding الشيخ الإسلام محمد شيخ الإسلام Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. He mentions so many things, but inshallah ta'ala, the most important points of them I will elaborate and speak on bi-ithnillahi al-kareem. First of all, the issue of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sitting on the throne. What is this regarding Ahlul Sunnah? What is the position Ahlul Sunnah have taken this? My question, inshallah, brothers, is our brother Muhammad Yasir Hadahullah, he tried to speak against Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah for accepting the issue of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala sitting on the throne. And he made it look like it was something Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah was the first to ever say it, and that nobody preceded him in this. But inshallah ta'ala, I want you to all listen to the names of these individuals and ask yourselves, will he be able to say the same in which he said about Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah? Can he say it about these people who are mountains in knowledge and in their righteousness and their obedience? First of all, the person who said or the narration is ascribed to regarding Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala sitting on his throne is Mujahid ibn Jabr. Mujahid is from أحد أكبر تلامذتي عبد الله بن عباس. One of the greatest students of Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنهما. When it came to the ayah in Surah Al-Isra, ayah 79, عسى أن يبعثك ربك مقاما محمودا, Mujahid, he mentions in that ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will sit on the throne. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will sit Muhammad next to himself. Mujahid mentions that. Who is Mujahid? The student of Abdullah ibn Abbas. Tabi'iyun Jalil. And he's the man who Sufyan al-Thawri said, إِذَا جَاءَكَ تَفْسِيرُ مُجَاهِدْ فَحَسْبُكَ بِهِ. If the tafsir of Mujahid comes to you, that is enough. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, when he brought the statement of Mujahid, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari did not reject it, nor did he disagree with it. And anyone who knows the tafsir of Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari rejects sometimes the views of some of the Mufassirin, and he chooses whichever he feels is strongest. But rather, he said in support of Mujahid, and this is what he said. He said, rahimahullah, فَقَدْ بَيَّنَ إِذًا بِمَا قُلْنَا أَنَّهُ غَيْرَ مُحَالٍ فِي قَوْلِ أَحَدٍ مِمَّنْ يَنْتَحِلُ الْإِسْلَامَ مَا قَالَهُ مُجَاهِدٍ. من أن الله تبارك وتعالى يقعد محمدا على عرشه. ابن جرير الطبري, this great مفسر who is referred to as إمام المفسرين, and he is the شيخ of all the مفسرين, he accepted the speech of Mujahid. Rather, he states and he mentions that this is the view held by all of the sects, and they have accepted it. Now my question to Muhammad Yasir is Ibn Jarir al-Tabari rahimahullah a mushabbih by saying this statement? Is also Mujahid who said this, is he a mushabbih? Rather, the people who've said this statement and accepted it is Imam Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah qatibatan bila niza'. He's the Imam of Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah wherever they are without any dispute. Imam Muhammad ibn Hanbal, who died the year 241. Imam Muhammad said, قَدْ تَلَقَتْهَا الْعُلَمَاءِ بِالْقَبُولِ. The scholars have accepted the narration, this narration, with acceptance. نُسَلِّمُ الْأَخْبَارَ كَمَا جَاءَةً. We accept these narrations as they are. Ishaq ibn Rahuya, who died the year 238, Hijriya. He said, الْإِيمَانُ بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ وَتَسْلِيمِ لَهُ. The believing of this hadith and surrendering to it. Abdul Wahhab ibn Abdul Hakim ibn Nafi' al-Warraq, who said, مَنْ رَدَّ هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ فَهُوَ جَهْمِي. Anyone who rejects this hadith is a Jahmi. Abu Dawood al-Sijistani, صاحب السنن, who died the year 275. He said, مَنْ أَنْكَرَ هَذَا فَهُوَ عِنْدَنَا مُتَّهَمْ. Anyone who rejects this, for us is suspected. مَا زَالَ النَّاسُ يُحَدِّثُونَ بِهَذَا. Then people, all of them, they used to say this. حسن ابن الفضل ابن سمح أبو علي الزعفراني البصيري بصيراني, he accepted it. إبراهيم الحربي, he accepted this narration. عبد الله ابن الإمام أحمد, he accepted it. محمد ابن عثمان ابن أبي شيبة, he accepted it. And rather he said, وبلغني عن بعض الجهال دفع الحديث بقلة معرفتهم في رده مما أجازه العلماء ممن قبلهم مما ذكرنا. He said, it has reached me that some of the ignorant individuals have rejected this hadith based on what? بِقِلَّةِ مَعْرِفَتِهِمْ, because of their little comprehension. مِمَّا أَجَازَهُ الْعُلَمَاءِ, that which the scholars have accepted and have taken into consideration. Abu Bakr al-Ajurri rahimahullah, in his kitab al-Sharia, he chaptered a whole bab. He said, بَابُ ذِكْرِ مَا خَصَّ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ بِهِ النَّبِيِّ. He chaptered a chapter and he said, the chapter of that which Allah has specifically given to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then he brought what? Maqamul Mahmud yawm al-qiyamah. And then he brought the statement of Mujahid. That Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is sitting on the throne and he sits and Nabiullah Muhammad on it. Shaykhul Islam Ibn Taymiyyah is from those people. This is the Aimatu Salaf. The statement of Mujahid was strengthened by Ibn Abi al-Asim, Ad-Darqutni, Al-Tabarani, Ibn Battah, Al-Barbahari, Ibn Najjad, Al-Baghawi, Al-Khalal, Al-Maruzi, Ibn Sarraj al-Shafi'i. They all strengthened it. Now my question is, are all of these individuals, are they mushabbiha? Are they what? Are they mushabbiha? Are they anthropomorphists? Have they fallen into giving Allah tabarak wa ta'ala resemblance towards his creation? Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, as he mentioned in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, that this hadith, Ahlu Sunnati qabiluh, they've accepted it and they've taken it into consideration. But there is a narration which Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah refuted, in which the reason why he refuted it is because there's iddirab, the hadith is contradicting itself. And so the one he strengthens, the one that negates from the one that affirms. The one that is negated is the one that says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the throne is bigger than him 4 fingers. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah refutes that and he proves that that is incorrect. Why? The reason why Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah refuted it is because of 2 answers. Muhammad Yasir, his ignorance and his lack of understanding, he only thought that Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah transmitted 1 reason. La, Ibn Taymiyyah gave 2 reasons. The first reason Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentioned is because the hadith is muddarib. The hadith is contradicting itself. And the reason, and its contradiction, one negating and one affirming. And he says, وَالْحَدِيثِ قَدَ رَوَاهُ بْنُ جَرِيرَ الطَّبَرِ فِي تَفْسِيرِهِ وَغَيْرِ وَلَفْظُهُ وَإِنَّهُ لَيَجْلِسُ عَلَيْهِ فَمَا يَفْضُلُ مِنْهُ قَدْرَ 4 أصابع بِالنَّفْيِ. He said, فَمَا يَفْضُلُ. The ma is nafi. So Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah says that riwayah goes against the other narration which says that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the throne is bigger than Allah 4 fingers. This narration says it's not bigger than him in 4 fingers. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah then goes to say that this narration which negates takes precedence over it. And he strengthens it. Rahimahullah wa rahmatan wasi'a. And this is what he said. He said, بَلْ هُوَ يَقْتَضِ أَنْ يَكُونَ الْعَرْشَ أَعْظَمُ مِنَ الرَّبِّ وَأَكْبَرُ وَهَذَا بَاطِلٌ مُخَالِفٌ لِلْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ وَلِلْعَقْلِ. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said that if we say that the throne, which has 4 fingers, bigger than Allah, then this would mean that the throne is bigger than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, هَذَا بَاطِلٌ. That is batil. The reason why it's batil, because it goes against the kitab of Allah, and it goes against the sunnah, and it goes against the logic. Pay attention. So the reason why it's batil is not because Ibn Taymiyyah is not inclined to it, but it goes against the kitab and the sunnah and the logic. And Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentions how it goes against the nusus al-wahiyyin, the text, and how it goes against logic. The way it goes, the logic, he said, is because it will necessitate that the throne is bigger than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and nothing can be bigger than him from his creation. But what is left is the text, the kitab and the sunnah. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is nothing greater than him. And he brings evidences for that. He brings everything for that. He brings evidences from the kitab. He brings evidences from the sunnah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَظْلِمُ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ لَا تُدْرِكُهُ الْأَبْصَارُ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. All of these evidences, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah proves it. الَّذِينَ يَحْمِلُونَ الْعَرْشَ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهُ. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah proves that all of it, that it can't be bigger than he, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the narration that is left is that the throne is not bigger than Allah. Now my question, brothers, is why does our brother Muhammad Yasir fall into the tashbih which he blames others for? When he had said that if we say that the throne, 4 fingers, it is not bigger than Allah because it goes against other texts, and we strengthened it in that, from that angle. If we say that he's sitting on the throne, what made you think that it would necessitate that the throne and of Allah are equal? Unless you have in your mind tashbih in which you're falling into, which you blame others for. And a lot do we see innovators fall into that which they blame others for. Inshallah ta'ala, I will conclude بإذن الله الكريم. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.
But inshallah ta'ala, brothers and sisters, those who are listening, that which is not hidden from you all is our brother Muhammad Yasir. Not once, not twice, but on many occasions, he has lied in that which he has claimed.